Hey everyone, it's Duncan Epping, yellowbricks.com, and today I've got something really cool for you. I'm going to show you how you can leverage HCI Mesh to actually connect a compute-only cluster to a vSAN data store. In this particular case, I already have vSAN enabled on the vSAN cluster, and of course, I'm going to configure the compute cluster to now connect to that vSAN cluster itself. I'm going to click Configure vSAN, and then I'm going to configure vSAN specifically for HCI Mesh Compute Only. So I select the vSAN HCI Mesh Compute Only option. I'm going to click Next and Finish. And now the vSAN client is going to be loaded on those hosts that are part of the Compute Only cluster. After I've done that, I get a new option which allows me to mount a remote or multiple remote data stores. And in this case, of course, I only have a single cluster in my environment, so I can only mount a single remote data store. I can select the mount remote data store option. I can select the data store that I would like to mount. I click next, next, finish, and now that data store is going to be mounted to the two hosts that belong to my compute only cluster, which also means that those hosts now have access to the storage in that remote cluster. Of course, a health check occurs. In my case, there was some exceeded latency, some latency thresholds exceeded, so that is going to be called out. Normally, you would solve those problems first, but just to show you what it looks like, I'm going to go ahead and mount the data store anyway. Now, when I provision the virtual machine, of course, I have the option to select my vSAN data store under storage. I can just select the vSAN data store and use the data store default policy, or of course I could select a different policy as well if I would like to, for instance, use something like RAID 5 or RAID 6 if my cluster would allow me to do that. I'm going to click next, next, finish, and then the virtual machine is going to be created. Of course, we didn't just stop there. We were also providing additional insights around where the data is being stored. So after the virtual machine has been provisioned, I can actually select the virtual machine and then go to the monitoring section to figure out where the data is being stored by vSAN. It actually shows you that in the physical placement section of the monitoring pane. So when you've selected that, it not only shows you that it's stored remotely, but it is also showing you where it potentially is stored. So you have all of that information available directly in the UI. Now, the other thing that we've introduced as part of 7.0 update 2 are some new options from a policy perspective. And we've introduced that specifically for HCI Mesh, because in some cases you may have data stores, for instance, which are encrypted, and other data stores which are not encrypted. So leveraging this new option called storage rules, you can now specify which data services need to be enabled on a cluster level in order for your virtual machines to be provisioned. So when you provision a virtual machine and you select a policy that has data address encryption as required, and for instance, compression as required, when you select that policy for the virtual machine, only the data store that has those options enabled are going to be presented as a valid option for you to provision the virtual machine to. So this is something, as mentioned, that is new as part of vSAN 7.0 update 2 as well. And with that, I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure to subscribe to the channel, and I hope to see you next time.